Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2227, Geography, Data Types. If you like what you see in this video, please subscribe and ring that bell. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Oh, another great new feature that appeared in Office 365. Now, this feature will not ever be in Excel 2019. It is Office 365 exclusive. You have to be a subscriber for this new data types feature. And right now they introduced two stocks in geography, but my sense is there's going to be a lot more of these as time comes as time goes by. All right, so here we have a bunch of cities in the United States. I'm going to choose those and choose geography, and they're going to go out to the internet and try and figure out what I mean by those cities, and we get this great little map icon on each one, which means that they were successful. All right, now here's some great new things that we can do with these linked data types. First thing, and by all means, this is not my favorite. Hover over the icon. It says Show Card, which is Control-Shift-F2. Click that, and you get some information from various places about that city. Population, area, latitude, longitude, time zone, description, and then down here it tells you where the data came from. All right, so, you know, that's great in case you don't have Google or Bing and you can't search something. But here's what's really cool is we have this new ability to pull data from cell A2 using a dot construct. So equal A2 dot, and then I can choose any of those. So if I would choose, for example, A2 dot population, it will return the population from the internet. Double click to copy that down, and I get populations for all those cities. Equal A2 dot population. Isn't that a wild formula? Something unlike anything we've ever seen. Now, if you happen to choose something that has spaces in it, like administration division 1, if I choose that, then you have to wrap it in square brackets. All right, so no square brackets needed. If it's a single word, no spaces, no punctuation. But so equal A2 population works, but otherwise you have to use that longer value. All right, equal A2 dot. Let's go with time zones. Eastern time zone, double click and copy it down, get to see the time zone. All right, now this is the fast and easy way to do this. They also provided a function for this, and I don't know anyone who would ever use this function. It's called equal or field value, equal field value. So A2 comma, see the tooltips there are not working, so let's just choose one of these from the list. Equal A2 area, but that's not the right way to do this. You have to do equal A2 comma area. There's still a bug there. Hopefully that'll get fixed over time. Use quotes. Yeah, so that autocomplete for field value is not working. All right, now in addition to having that new field value, we have a new error to go along with that. So if I would ask for equal field value of A2 comma something, and doesn't know what something is, then we get a hashtag field exclamation error that shows you that. The other place where this error will appear temporarily is if you change a value. So let's change from San Diego to Los Angeles. I'm going to press enter and watch these four cells right here. They're temporarily going to change to field errors, but then pop in with the right value. So that case means that, hey, we're going out to the internet to try and figure out what data to use. All right, now here's some really cool things. So population, state, and of course these don't have to match, time zone. I'll get rid of this one here, and I will add a filter to this. All right, now what I'd like to do is I'd like to see these cities arranged in order from east to west. All right, so I'm going to open the drop down, and we have this new thing, select field, and I can sort by something that's not even in the spreadsheet. For example, longitude, sort largest to smallest, and we go Miami, Cleveland, Atlanta, Chicago. Yeah, that seems to be right, going from the East Coast to the West Coast, right? So that's a cool trick. Now, this is working with cities. It also works with countries. Here I have the A2 dot national anthem. I get a different list for countries, probably a lot more information available for countries or states or provinces, and so on like that. You know, another thing that can go wrong is if you put in a country that does not exist. All right, so we'll put in the lost country of Atlantis. Then you get that, what are you talking about? That little icon there. We need help with this text. And then a data selector pops up where you can search, and that's not what I want. So you can put in, you know, another country, another fictitious place, and then finally I'm at Italy and I choose that. Now the first thing is I get the card, and then I have to type select to actually have that change to Italy, and then copy down to get the national anthem. All right, so these are cool. These are great. It's a brand new thing for Excel. I've been hearing about this for a couple of years, this project, and it's finally arrived with both geography and stocks. All right, so you can put in some companies here. Let's put in KO for Coke. All right, they were able to resolve that to Coca-Cola Company. Equal A2 dot. We've got all kinds of stock information, the CEO, the change, percentage change, and so on. The thing that's interesting here is that they're going to give us the current price, but there's no way to get like a history of prices. When I imagine all kinds of people need a way to go back and like store the historical prices. There'll be all kinds of macros that'll pop up for that, and so on. Also, pressing F9 to recalc does not recalculate this because it's expensive to go out to the internet and get all of these. So back here on the data tab, refresh all will force these to be refreshed. All right, so it's not going to recalculate all the time, which is actually a good thing. All right, so this is one of those new features discussed in my book, Microsoft Excel 2019 Inside Out. You can pre-order that book now. Click the I in the top right-hand corner. Linked data types. First two are geography and stocks. It's exclusive to Office 365, since it requires downloading data. Type some cities. Select the cities marked as geography. They're on the data tab. Hover over the icon to see the card, or a great new form of the construct, equal A2.population. Remember, wrap population in square brackets if the value you want, if the name of the value has spaces or any kind of punctuation. There's a new field value function. It's not working well when you use the autocomplete. New field, exclamation error, and then cool trick. Sort by a column that is not there if you use the filters. The field error appears during refresh. That just means it's going out. I guess if you were offline, that field error would appear forever. And then data refresh in order to force a recalc. To download the workbook from today's video, visit the URL in the YouTube description. To learn about more new features in Excel, please subscribe and click that bell. Well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.